age the seasoning.
A fairy tale.
Four of my nieces.
Good morning. Day one in my new home. I'm trying to find some light. It is very gloomy outside, but I want you guys to appreciate this great natural lighting. You guys see the discoloration? I feel like I can show you guys this now. So you see all these shades. This is like golden, this is dark, and then there's my face, which does have a little bit of makeup on it. All of that was from the very strong allergic reaction that I had to moving. So when I tell you guys that moving is stressful for me, I need you guys to appreciate that I'm not speaking lightly about that. Like, I mean that. Like, moving is incredibly stressful. And I kept trying to figure out, like, why was my neck breaking out? I was just like, oh, are you overworking yourself? Are you... No, I was very afraid of this next step that I was taking. But now, having spent my first night here, I feel amazing. I feel like this light is coming through, even though it's gloomy outside. Like, it's super gloomy outside, but this is all the light. And like, while I was like laying on my air mattress, I was like drawing up floor plans and stuff like that. Like, that's how you know you're really excited about a space, when you're just like compelled to try to put together, I'm trying to see if it's the best angle, you're compelled to try to put together a floor plan. So I've been working with that, and I'm so super excited. I'm going to invest in an amazing bed. I've been researching beds since I was in my old place, because that bed was a terrible bed. I just didn't notice that it was a terrible bed, and I thought a lot of the physical pain that I was having was because of the PTSD symptoms, but a lot of it was just because I was sleeping on a terrible bed, and so it would create different pains throughout my body. So I had already begun the process of thinking through finding a mattress and bed that was more suitable so that I could get proper rest. Rest has been one of the most essential habits that I have learned in the last year and a half. And so in me understanding the value of that, I want to make sure that my sleeping quarters is designed for me to get the best sleep possible. What I'm hoping to do with my main space, what I'm calling the great room, is to have sleeping quarters, living room quarters for socializing and lounging, like socializing, like having a couple of friends over or just enjoying myself. And then also, I really would love a dining space. That's ambitious because the space is small, but I'm thinking I can do sort of like a smaller, like bistro size, maybe that's really small, but like a smaller round dining space that like serves double duty.
One of the reasons, one of the things that really sold me on this place versus the other place truly is the little office nook.
And the other furniture piece that is going to be remarkable will be my couch. And again, that one isn't necessarily for any sort of like health reasons, that's just a personal reason. Sort of spending the last almost 2.5, close to 3 years with some undertones of homelessness. Granted, I always had a roof over my head, and there was great provision in many of the spaces that I lived. When I'm speaking of homelessness, I mean the sense of being without a home, sort of being transient. Feeling that way for the last 2.5, 3 years is difficult, and it's upsetting to say the least. And so what I want to do for my current home is actually make it a home. And I do believe that one of the ways that you make an apartment or a house a home is by investing in the things that you want. So those are the two pieces that you will see a heavy investment in, and I'm super excited because those two pieces are also informing the layout as well as the focal point and the style of my new home. And I'm just super excited about getting started.
So here is my empty apartment. Okay, so this is the sun-filled view when you first walk into the apartment. You have that space over there, and then if you pan this way, you have sort of this space here, this gray thing here on the floor. That is the air mattress that I've been sleeping on for a while. It's kind of hard to get a sense of the depth of the space, but I will tell you, I am 100% pleased and totally happy with my decision. So I'm trying to just pan so you guys can see how cozy the living, dining, and bedroom area is gonna be. This is like me way over in the corner. And how much light comes in, because like right now I don't have any studio lights or anything like that. It's just pure light cascading into the place, and I love it, love it, love it. Ish space. These are the books that are left over from purging and giving away books on Instagram. And then I just put here some photos. That's me and my son from a few years ago. These are four of my nieces and my son there, because I love them. So then after that, you come into this hallway, which one of the things that sold me on this studio was the fact that it had separate spaces, which made it feel much larger and more homey. It's a very cozy bathroom. I love that it is just all white and there's all this space. I mean, excuse me, that it's all white and it gives the impression of more space. But if you can see, the footprint is not very large at all. The ceilings are very high and I really appreciate that. The light in here is absolutely perfect, and the mirror and just the height of all that is very, very perfect. The vanity is quite small and there's no back to the toilet area, so I'm going to do a bit of a DIY project here so that way I can increase the level of shelving. But again, that will be in some more of the design, the decorating videos that we do. But this is the bathroom, perfect for like my energized mornings. Although I'll probably never use this window in terms of it being open, I'm happy that there's a window in there because that brings in a lot of light as well. So then, still in the hallway, if you turn to the left, you come into my walk-in slash step-in closet, and I am in love with this closet right now. Like, I like that. So let me see if you guys can, I don't know if you guys can see me or not, if you guys can see me, but like, this is lighting in my walk-in closet without me having any studio lights or anything like that. So I'm kind of in love with the fact that the lighting in here is fantastic, and the space. So that arm out and this arm out, I'm touching the walls, but it's the width of my arm span, which is kind of amazing. And it's likely deeper than that. Again, I will get some measurements and put that in there, but hardwood floors in here. I guess you can kind of see the footprint a little bit more with these things here. I'm super excited about turning this into a stunning closet with my capsule wardrobe and the hangers and whatnot. Again, that will be in another video. And I also like that going up, there's tons of vertical space, because these boxes that I have not unboxed are giving me an idea of the additional shelving that I could potentially put in here. And then also, I want to see if I can show you guys this. So if I step out into the hallway, you see how like here there's wall and then there's a door space there. What's nice about that, because I don't have double doors, is that I come in here and then I have the depth of this wall that I can actually put something there. So like, if you look at the depth of this box, this is how deep this area is. And so if I wanted to put a dresser in here, or maybe, you know, something for shoes or whatever, like there's so much space inside of this closet to be able to work with. And I'm kind of in love with it. I'm kind of super, super pumped and excited about how large this space is and the amount of storage that it offers me. And I love that it has a light as well, because then, you know, it's like going into this awesome space. So then after that, you come into the office nook, which is off here to the right. Again, I love the fact that there's this window here. I always talk about, like, if I could have been any other of God's creatures, I totally would have been a tree, because I like seasons. And I just feel like trees experience all of God's seasons in a very beautiful way. But anyway, you come into the office nook, which since I've unpacked, you can kind of see how deep this desk is and how much stuff can actually be like piled on here. But I love this office nook. There's so much, like there's this window here that I can add some decor to, this wall here, some decor. The lighting in this space is also really awesome. But you know, there's just great space. There's great space for a chair and to move the chair out. And then I have all of this wall space there. The other thing that I really love about the office space, and I sort of demolished the shelving when I was just trying to get everything unboxed, is that I do have three shelves. The main shelf, there's another shelf, and then there's a shelf up here. I'm so excited about organizing that and finding like the storage that I'll need. And then even, you know, the ceilings are a little higher, so maybe I can put like some baskets or things up there. I like that the depth of the above the desk storage, it's deeper, so that way I actually have like headspace and I won't have to worry about hitting my head. It's like a proper little office nook, which I'm so thrilled about. So yeah, that's like super awesome. And I just love that it's deeper because it just makes it cozier. And this is gonna just be my corner to create, whether I'm creating YouTube videos, writing speeches, letters, whatever it is. It's just a cozy place to do all of that. And I'm so excited that it is built into my studio space. So then if you go over to the right, you go over to the final room, which is my kitchen area. And the kitchen does have a separate light. The switch works for both lights, but I like that there is actual lighting over the kitchen and lighting over the office. It really sort of separates the spaces. I like that my fridge is cozy because you guys know that for the most part, I'm eating for one. I'm not a fan of bulk shopping because I think that it is very wasteful often when you are one person because things expire, etc. But I just love that the fridge is just nice and lean, and it'll always appear full because it's a smaller fridge. I love that this over the head storage is going to be cabinetry that I'm going to use for kitchen instead of office space, just because the depth of the office space to me just is like, that's office and then this is the beginning of the kitchen. And so this is unorganized, but I want to show you guys because it'll be organized and I'm going to be so in love with it. I'm so excited about doing that. There's tons of storage. I put all of these items over here just for right now, just because truly I was unpacking. The floors are like this laminate gray, so I'm excited about getting a rug to put over the bottom of that. The under the sink storage, I am kind of excited about this because it'll give me a way to be able to do recycling. So I'll be able to have like a trash can, a paper recycling, and a potential plastic recycling, or maybe it'll be like a trash can and just a regular recycling because I don't use very much plastic, and then I can put like my cleaning things and stuff like that. But there's just great. So this is a lot of cabinetry. I obviously unorganized, but I'm just trying to show you guys how much storage space. But then also I wanted to point out, if your kitchen is like mine and you have a cabinet right above a heat source, what you don't want to store in here are seasonings, because the heat will actually age the seasonings and then they'll be stale. And so you don't want to put those right there, even though it seems the most intuitive to be able to grab. Now, if you have a different cabinetry that's maybe thicker than that, maybe it won't matter, but my cabinetry is not that strong. But anyhoodle, there is tons of storage. I'm gonna get that all organized and beautiful and make it look like a pantry. And then I do have drawers on this side. I have, this will probably be a silverware drawer. This will be a bigger like utensil drawer, probably a junk drawer as it's already becoming. And then this is just like a bigger space. But again, I am so grateful for all the storage. It's like there's so much that can be done with this kitchen, and even the storage that's up there. I like that it is a blank canvas and that it's white, because that literally means I can decorate it however I want because I'm working with a blank canvas. And oh, how I'm going to do that. So yes, that is the full apartment.